No, it's the people's champion. I'm back. Richie, you know what I'm talking about? Oh, whatever, man. Yeah, let me get that job, man. You know what I'm talking about? You know what, man? You know, I was being seriously harassed, man. A lot of women is trying to get at the world champion, man. And I just want, I want to really tell y'all seriously, get your money together. You know what I'm talking about? You understand me? I have a little poem. You know, I want to start this segment out with a little poem. I am not a nerd. I do not wear glasses. I want y'all to treat me equal, because players pay taxes. You know what I'm talking about? For real. You know what I'm talking about? See, and this is not fair, man. I get to this singing and whatnot, and I mean, they say I look like a mix between, you know, Marvin Gaye and the Elder Barge. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm talking about? Oh, whatever, man. Now, we're going to get back to the subject, man. I have a new co-host, man, and like the last co-host, you understand me? She was grabbing on my shoulders and whatnot when the thing was out, and I said, listen to me. Listen to me. You know, I'm not Republican or nothing like that. But I got to change, we could believe. You're going to have to drop some change on the jam. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm talking about? Getting back to the subject, man.
Oh, boy.
We have some callers calling in, and we want to address it. Anybody who's calling in, we want to get with you. Call in right now. We're asking you, what do you think about these kids having sex? And I'd like to ask some personal questions. When did we start having sex here in the studio audience? You know. Oh, man, I mean, you know what I'm talking about? You know the number is 212-283, you know, 3437. You know what I'm saying? And I was reading this from a thing, and the 7 was missing. But, you know, I am so glad that God made me a genius versus just a pretty boy. In fact, he did them both. Favor ain't fair, man. Y'all go out there and eat your Wheaties and stay a sweetie. You know what I'm Listen, man, get your heart right, man. It ain't my... Be mad at God because he did this.
What's yeah, when did the cereal?
Yeah,
thing?
We're talking.
What's
listen,
cereal
listen,
thing?
Man. I tell you, man, you gotta lay off of it. That's what.
So stop eating the cereal.
No, what don't eat too much of it.
You do. Wheaties is good
not
for
the
you.
Fruit Loops.
Don't get see
no the Fruit Loops. No Fruit Loops.
Oh, you on that Fruity Pebble blast? You know, we got a lot of Happy Feet out there.
We got Cocoa Puffs.
A whole bunch of Cocoa Puffs and people with broke wrists. You understand me eating? You know, Fruity Pebbles. You know what I'm saying?
What about Honeycomb?
See,
that's even worse.
That's even worse. You done put me on the Honeycomb blast. But I want to get on it. You know, we having a lot of fun up in here. When did we really start having sex? Because now we old buzzards. Now we want to tell the kids, you know, oh, man, this is wrong. Wait till you marry. You need to, you know, be like T.D. Jakes and watch for snakes. You know what I'm talking about? When did we start having it? Seriously, when did we start having it?
I mean, actually, for me, I was 12 going into 13.
Are you serious?
Wow.
Like,
yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Seriously.
What you talking about?
28, so you know.
Hey, I'm 27.
Wow.
That's just it. See, me, I'm the new 24.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying?
So are you going to be able to tell us when you had sex?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I was 27.
Wow.
When I first started. You know,
wow.
I was a virgin. I was a 27-year-old virgin. And I,
Wow.
You know.
Well, no, that's fine because that means you did a lot throughout your life and you stayed focused, obviously, on something else.
No, I'm not even going to let you go down that path. I got 4 kids, 25, and, you know.
Wow.
I'm just pulling your leg. I started early. I started doing everything early. I had kids. I'm 17 years a senior.
Wow.
You know, so it wasn't, you know, so much of having sex early. You know, I had kids early, you know.
So you're having my baby. You know. No, come on, man. Jodeci made that
that's
up.
Right.
Oh,
that's right.
Oh, man. Oh, my life type, Nick.
But just to talk about teen, you know, teen, it's a scary thing, man. I'm talking from experience, okay? I conceived at 16 and had a baby at 17.
Wow.
I damn near lost my mind, you know. But I had a great support factor behind me, you know. You know, a lot of times, and I tell a lot of people all the time, you know, when your kids get in trouble, don't abandon them, man. You know, that's when they need you the most. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Because I'm going to tell you, I needed my mother. She was right there. She didn't do a whole lot as far as, you know, financially or anything like that, but she was my pillar of strength. You understand what I'm saying? Whenever I wasn't feeling a certain way, she would always be there to lift me up and say, hey, man, it's going to be all right. You know what I'm saying? We're going to do it like this or we're going to do it like that. And, you know, that's all I needed. All I needed was somebody there to say it was going to be all right. You know what I'm saying? Plain and simple.
See,
I got two daughters, 25 right now, and it's been all right. My sons is 21.
How many grandkids?
Three of them in college. I got two grands.
Wow.
Yeah, so, I mean, you know, started early. And my daughters, they kind of started late, you know. Mm-hmm. Only one of my daughters had a baby. And it wasn't, you know, no teenage pregnancy or nothing like that. You know, I try to, you know, education, man, you know.
Yeah.
You don't walk down the path and then allow your people to do the same
exactly.
thing, you know. If it happens, it happens, but, you know.
But then, you know, take the...
Absolutely. All my kids was... then went to college, and, you know, my son is graduating from college, you know, and that's what it is. I was there. You got to take care of yours. When if you're out there and you teen pregnancy and you're getting all that good stuff, and know you better take care of your own, man.
But that was kind of, you know, actually that was kind of a good thing, you know, them actually seeing you have them at an early age, because they was able to go further and finish college and almost, you know what I'm saying, Sonora's finished college, you know what I'm saying, Demo, he's gonna be out of college.
Mm-hmm.
So once you see your parents do it early, I don't think you're gonna do it as early as them. You're gonna try to prevent it because you've seen what, you know, they went through, and you don't want to make the
exactly.
same mistake, you know. You want to go a little bit further before you start having kids.